with two successful ventures. She was the founder and CEO of Titan Securities, and also the founder and CEO of Ski, the social networking site which launched in 2015. Ms. Jenny, if you please want to join us on stage. We also have Ibu Noni Purnomo. Ibu Noni is the President, Director, and CEO of Uber Group Holdings. After accomplishing her Bachelor of Engineering from the University of Newcastle and earned her Master of Business Administration for Finance and Marketing, managing the whole group business portfolio for Uber Group Holdings has been a challenge for Noni, and yet she's excelled and thrived.
Thank you, Anthony. First, I just want to take 30 seconds to say an off-topic. I think after our panel is actually lunch. So we all can, you know, hang around for 20 minutes and then we're going to have lunch. Second of all, obviously, I'm here because of my business partner, who is the amazing woman, Shinta, who's doing this event today. And of this panel, I believe that I am the foreign child coming from Los Angeles. So I wanted to share more of the global perspective than that of the data from Indonesia. To give a brief of my background, as you mentioned, I am a serial entrepreneur. I've been an entrepreneur since I was in my early 20s, fresh out of college. I spent almost 15 years on Wall Street, founded two broker-dealers. Those who do not know what a broker-dealer is, it's pretty much similar to a Goldman Sachs, but in a much smaller scale. At one time, my first broker-dealer, we managed almost a third of $1 billion in assets. Both of my broker-dealers have been acquired. So currently, I'm with Shinta as my partner and co-founder. We're currently running two companies right now. I call it my third and my fourth.
Do you see that there is increasing participation there? Do you see that there is more participation there as compared to maybe Wall Street? Or do you see that there's actually greater opportunities in IT industries?
Yeah, I fit in both industries quite well. As I mentioned, I was on Wall Street and now I'm in the tech industry. In Silicon Valley, actually, there is somewhat of a saying that women who look very feminine are often ignored in tech settings because they literally said that those women are too pretty to code. So, you know, it's a sexist type of a statement, and that's one. But in terms of data, because of the economic growth around the world coming from Wall Street, we all know that the stock market has risen quite strong in the United States. And so economic growth from the United States spread around the world. A lot of the labor force for women overall has risen. The women basically, because of the income level and the education, a lot of the women, they choose to go back to get higher education in STEM or STEAM, so they get themselves out of the labor force. That's one. The second part is because their husband make more money because of the economic growth in the industry, they felt that a one income is sufficient in certain family so that wife can go back to get a higher education. So currently, the data, of course, is like Wall Street, goes up and it goes down. But currently, as stated, a lot of women are going back to get higher education in STEM and STEAM role because, again, right now, it's very hot. Well, if I was just going to add two pieces would be, of course, we talk about data of women entering the STEM and STEAM workforce. The data, you know, that once when women enter, there are 41% versus men of only 17% that literally leaves the workforce. So that's more than double. So women do go in, but we have to find that reason why do 41% of those women who do go in leave the industry after X number of years versus the men, there's only 17%. Now that's one, and of course, you know, a lot of data is still coming out. The second part I wanted to add to it is the current era. What's hot these days? Virtual reality, chatbots. Are the chatbots here yet in Indonesia? You guys heard of chatbots? There's a lot of them in the United States. Robots and mobile. Now, if you talk about these four that I just mentioned, these are literally robots. They're not human beings. So when it comes to education, women can program these robots so that these robots, of course they're not human beings, cannot discriminate. So in these four industries, AI, virtual reality, chatbots, the robot industry are picking up, you know, women can be behind these robots to be the coders, to code these robots so that it will be more of a fair assessment in the future that we don't have to compare the men going to be doing the code versus the women will literally code the robot to be more machine than that of human, where we have the feeling of sexism and discrimination. Actually, since we started with this women panel with Cheryl Sandberg, I want to take a piece of data from Cheryl Sandberg. She recently said that at our current pace of change, the word is change, we are changing, it would take 100 years for women to reach parity in a C-suite executive roles as that of a man. 100 years. I think that's too long. Now, you know, I believe, and I've done research, that there are just two simple ways to fix this problem, I believe. One, of course, is that we have to believe in more diversified teams, because there are data out there that a diversified team with women and men perform better, were more creative, and companies have higher revenue and profits. So why not think diversification? And when we